Vincent Inneo, one of the upcoming actors out of the movie Centurion A.D. Hi, Vincent. How are you today?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
Good. I'm glad to have you here. So you're in Centurion A.D. What role do you play in this movie?
I play the FBI agent, Rocco Rinaldi.
Rocco Rinaldi, that's an interesting name. So, as an FBI agent in this movie, were you at all intimidated? Was your character intimidated? Was he nervous? I mean, all these dead bodies popping up. Were you at all, kind of give us an idea of what your character is like in the movie.
Not intimidated.
That's
this
good
is
thing.
What he does for his life. This is his living. He's been there, done that, seen it all. But when he gets that little sniff,
is that what the FBI agents get?
He goes after his prey like no one else you ever seen. He gets to the point where he's 100% sure that he's got the right guy in his sights. And the movie takes you through where he's at and where he ends up, and it's not where everybody thinks.
Wow! So this is going to be...
You're going to have to wait, folks.
They're going to have to wait. Yeah. So is this a suspense sort of movie? Will it keep people kind of on the edge of their seat?
It will keep them on the edge of their seat. There are some twists in it. And that's about as far as I want to go without giving too much away.
Okay, don't want to give it away just yet. We want to make people go see it. That's the key.
Exactly.
Now, as far as your character is concerned, though, are you similar to your character or are you in real life? Are you similar to the character Rocco Rinaldi or is he totally out of the box for you?
Okay. There are similarities.
Okay.
I think as an actor, you want to bring in things that are you into your character to make it more comfortable. There's things that he does that I wouldn't normally do as me.
And what are some of those things?
I'm not telling
you. You're not telling me?
Yeah.
Is that going to give away the movie?
No. People who know me, I've got kind of like a short fuse.
Ah, you got a short fuse.
Right, but the way I would describe it is I will bend as far back as I want to, but don't be around when I snap forward.
Whoa.
And I have that under control.
You have that under control.
Right. Now, in the course of the movie, you're going to see a combination of Rinaldi and a combination of this guy. And I'm talking to the police captain. That's all I'm going to say.
So that's going to be a pretty intense scene.
That is a pretty good scene, yeah.
So I guess you kind of drew on some of your own personality in that part.
I think you have to.
Well, I bet the moviegoers are going to see that when they watch then.
I hope so. I hope we did a good job for them.
Yeah. No, the movie itself, it was shot, I understand, over the course of 14 months. What was the whole shooting process work? Like working with the director, Brian, and the rest of the cast and the crew. Can you kind of give us a feel for what that whole 14 months was like?
It was long.
Long, yeah. 14 months is a long time.
I think there's something that the audience has to understand. You know, when you have a budget of $1 million to $20 million for your movie,
that makes it easy.
Oh yeah, you shoot every day. You pay your actors. You pay your cast and your crew. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and the movie gets done. Boom, 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 boom.
Wow. One of the things you just mentioned is the, you know, the cast, the cost, you know, what was you guys not really receiving a lot. So obviously it had to be a project that you were really, you know, believed in. That or you wouldn't have committed so much time to being a part of. So what about the project itself attracted you to say, okay, I'm willing to commit 14 months, work long hours, do all of this, and right now I haven't seen maybe the paycheck up front.
Okay. 14 months was not committed to. We thought we'd get this puppy in a can by 4 to 6 months, but it just didn't work that way. So that part of it, we'll keep in abeyance.
Kind of took a little bit longer than you thought.
Took a little longer than we thought.
But you hung in there.
We all hung in there.
You all hung in there.
The nice thing about the cast and crew about this particular film is everybody was committed, everybody was dedicated, and we knew that once we started this thing, we were gonna finish it no matter how long it took. And I think when you see the end product, you're gonna understand why we continued to do it, because it's, I will share to you with our editor mentioned to our director. He came in and he looked at some of our dailies and he basically said, You have a lot of good scenes here.
Okay.
And when you have a lot of good scenes, you're going to have a really good movie.
Mm,
and
so
this is
intriguing.
Coming from an independent guy who has nothing
to do with
us.
The movie. Well, you heard it here first.
Mm-hmm.
He's already told you that there are a lot of good scenes. So if you could tell us one of your favorites then from the movie. Just one.
The scenes?
One of your favorite scenes. Just give us one.
That would be the confrontation that I have with the captain.
Oh, the one you kind of alluded to earlier.
Yeah.
That confrontation.
It went so well and so smooth. And then you and then you see Rocco get slapped down at the end of that scene. It was a good scene.
You're
gonna like that one.
Something that makes you proud as an actor.
Yeah.
Something that makes you proud. Well, that's good when you can look at the finished product and say, I'm proud of this.
Yeah. I think we've got a good one here. My family, there were a lot of family members that were police officers, state troopers, mm-hmm. and like I said, Rocky and the FBI. I'm military, old military. So those experiences enable me to draw and bring it into Rocky, Rinaldi.
Okay.
And I think that's where it came from.
Okay, that's fair.
The hardest part about being Rinaldi was not the subject matter, but the audience that we were going to show it through.
Right. Now, when you say audience, you were going to show it through, what do you mean by that?
Christian community. Teenagers, you know, the younger group. You will not find one bad word by anyone in this script.
Wow, that's a refreshing thing because I think so often what you see on the big screen, I don't want to say think, you see something totally contrary to that.
Yes.
So do you believe that since you've done something for no cursing, anything that's like what we normally see, do you think that's going to really draw in that faith-based audience?
Yeah, right, because you're getting a PG rating and not a PG-13 or an R or whatever they, however they rate.
Mm-hmm.
And as an actor, the challenge as an actor, especially this guy.
Uh-huh.
Every four-letter word you can think of, you wanted to say.
Oh, so it kind of made you think outside the box.
It was all kept inside, and the emotions came out with the lines, but not the language.
That sounds exciting. I bet moviegoers are going to be excited to see you. From what I've heard, it sounds like an exciting movie.
I bet
there is going to be a lot of anticipation for people to, get out there, go see it. So,
thank you.
So we are behind the scenes with Vincent. From the upcoming movie Centurion A.D. So thanks so much for joining us, Vincent.
Welcome. Thank you.